So by now, you know that this video blog and podcast are about how to be effective communicators and how we can interact with people who think differently about topics than we do. And recently I was thinking about the direction of our video blog and was wondering about where we should go. And I thought to myself that in the Gospel of John, we find Jesus, the master communicator, having lots of interactions with other people and people interacting with each other about Jesus. And I thought there's a lot for us to learn there. Jesus continues to be able to have conversations with people, effectively communicating who he is and leaving them wondering and pondering deep questions. So I thought it would be really cool for us to take some time to look at different accounts of Jesus talking with other people and other people talking about Jesus in the Gospel of John so that we could learn how to do it and be more effective in communicating important spiritual truths with other people. So that's what we're going to do. No doubt you've heard about a man named John the Baptist. He was Jesus' second cousin. Jesus' mother Mary and John's mother Elizabeth were first cousins. And John was born about 6 months before Jesus was born. And his whole job, his whole responsibility, according to the Bible, was to prepare the way of the Lord, to speak out and to communicate to others that God's Messiah was coming. And you know, that was an amazing thing to do. That's quite a significant honor. But as John became a more influential and significant person, preaching out in the wilderness and crowds gathering and starting to baptize people, you have to think that at some point he was starting to feel kind of impressed with the opportunities he was having and the influence that he was having. But then that moment comes when Jesus shows up to be baptized by John. And John has a crucial moment of opportunity. Is he going to fulfill his mission, or is he going to be challenged by Jesus taking over his spot, his credit, his place of influence? And that's where the encounter with John the Baptist begins. So one day, a big crowd gathered around John the Baptist, and they asked him a hard question. Are you the Messiah, or are you one of the prophets? And John said, no, I am not the Messiah, and I'm not a prophet. I am a voice crying out in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord, quoting a prophecy from Isaiah. So John was making it very clear. I am not the Messiah. I'm not the one that you're looking for. But I know the one you're looking for, and I am making an announcement that he is coming. And that's John's role, and he accepts it. And that's remarkable, because John is the older cousin. John is the one who already has an audience, already has a crowd, already has disciples. And that could have been very satisfying and ego-boosting for him. He could have said, hey, maybe I am the Messiah. Maybe I ought to make a run for this. But no, he understands that Jesus, his cousin, is the Messiah, the promised Son of God. And he understands his role is to honor him and to declare him and to lift him up. That requires tremendous humility, but it also recognizes that John understood that he was not the man, but he was announcing the man. What does this conversation between a group of people and John the Baptist tell us, and specifically tell us about Jesus? Well, a little while later, John the Baptist was talking to two of his disciples who wanted to know what he thought about Jesus. And John simply said, "Behold, the Lamb of God," which was a statement of his messiahship. And when John said this, they immediately left him and began to follow Jesus as his disciple. And you know what? John was okay with that. Because John said, I must decrease so that he, Jesus, might increase. He was okay with giving the honor and the glory and all the credit to Jesus because he understood who Jesus was. And that's remarkable.
There are a lot of famous stories about people taking credit for other people's work. One of the most notorious is Walter Keane and his wife, Margaret. She's known to have been the painter, the artist of these well-known series of paintings of small children with large eyes. But for many years, people thought Walter was the artist because he claimed to be the artist. He met and married Margaret and realized she had the talent and began to kind of enslave her and force her to paint painting after painting while he took credit for being the artist. And he got richer and richer and lived a very, very lavish lifestyle, big homes, mansions, hung out with Hollywood stars. Meanwhile, she was spending 16 hours a day, almost like a slave, being forced to churn out these different paintings. Eventually, when the day of reckoning came through a court case, the judge actually made them both paint a painting in real time in the courtroom. And when it was clear that she had a wonderful talent and he had no talent at all, the gig was up and he was debunked as the artist. And you know, he could have shared in all of that. He could have had as much money as he did. He could have enjoyed the lavish lifestyle. He could have honored his wife and enjoyed her talent, but he wanted the credit. He wanted the glory. He wanted the honor, not just the money. And that's a stark contrast with John the Baptist, who was willing to say, it's not about me. It's about Jesus and God's plan. And when you have that kind of example at the beginning of Jesus's ministry, it says something about Jesus, and it says something about a person like John letting his ministry decrease so that Jesus's ministry could expand. And that says something about how we're to honor people in our lives. Who are the people in your life that are authorities, parents, teachers, employers, seniors, pastors, spiritual leaders, people that you regard? Are you willing to honor them, to recognize them, to give them the credit that they deserve, even when they're younger than you, even when they're less experienced than you are? That humility says a lot about the kind of way we should be and the kind of communication we should possess. Finally, they said, who are you? Give us an answer to take back to those who sent us. What do you say about yourself? John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, I am the voice of one calling in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord. John later said, I baptize with water, but among you stands one who you do not know. He is the one who comes after me, the straps of whose sandal I am not worthy to untie.